Hello, so today's class is on time management. And to help you understand what I want to tell you about time management, I'm sharing my screen. So to define time management, this is what type of definition that is given here. Next is what are time management skills or what should I say? Most important things that should be there in to help you manage your time. And these are the skills that helps you actually manage time at the end of it. So first is organization. So when I have everything scattered around and all sorts of stuff to do and not organized, not planned, I actually waste time. Instead of that, I can just organize things that I have on a day-to-day basis. Suppose I am a student and I have a family to take care of, or I am part of a family. There are friends with whom I should network, talk, have fun on a regular basis, because this is the time when we can really communicate with our friends without thinking or without, fearing that we are wasting time and all these things. So this is the prime time for our friendship also. We need to give equal importance to all of them. And at the same time, we need to think of our bigger goal, the bigger goal that we have in our life. So some organization is required. Otherwise, we will all be wasting time or investing too much time on one activity, the others will go neglected. Next is prioritization. Now, suppose I know that I have four things in my life that needs to be done, and needs to be contributed to on a regular basis. One is a long-term goal, where one is something that I am doing at the present, like you're working in your present company or and if you're a student, your student life and your family responsibility and your other life, friendship, hobbies, etc. So these are four things that are very important in your life. They need to be prioritized. Which one do you want to give most important first? Or among these four things, what is it that needs to be given much more prioritization, much more priority before you move on to other stuff? So that is something which will help us manage our time. Next important stuff is goal setting. Now, what we all do is we just set certain limited goals for our life. Suppose when we are young, we have only one aim in life, to grow up. And when our parents ask us various things, we not very sure about what we are saying. Most of the cases, we just say that I want to be this or I want to be that. Gradually, that makes takes a formation. And we, modulate our life or plan our life to have that in our life or to have that materialized in our life. So we set certain goals. Once we have finished our studies and joined a company, that is a time when most of us find our goals to be fulfilled. But believe me, that is one goal that has been successful. We need another one to help us carry out through the next part of our life. Just because I had a goal of getting a job and to help my family survive won't be enough won't be enough to carry me through life. I need to have a bigger goal. We all have a bigger goal, but we don't set that goal up really. We want a good bank balance. We want capacity to travel to various parts of the world, to visit places, to provide for our family, to keep our family members happy, to secure our family and our futures and all these things. We all have these goals. But these are smaller ones. If we actually had a proper goal, what we would have is, I am 30 years old. I want to travel to so and so places, or travel to 10 different continents, 10 different countries. So a little bit of going into the details, finding out what type of things we can go and visit, what may be roughly an estimated cost and the present time, and then maybe multiply it and see what will be the cost in 5 years or so. Because you may decide that by 35 or 40, you won't have that much of energy to visit those countries. So likewise, you need to plan out of various chunks of your life. And I mean, set those goals, then plan them out. Communication is another time-consuming factor that we have in life. We either find it very difficult to communicate and don't communicate, and as a result, we have to take on more pressure, more burden, more work, because we did not have the skills to communicate properly and delegate or provide the work to some other people. Or sometimes when we don't keep quiet, we may be trying to explain something, trying to tell you something, but because of our lack of communication skills, we are not actually being clear. And I am not talking about English communication skill. I'm talking about communicating as a whole. Because if you look at yourself, you'll find that you have a huge problem communicating properly, even in your language, when you are doing it in for a specific purpose. If you are doing your communication for your work-related purpose, you have a problem communicating there. And that is why you have problem communicating in English when you are trying to do it. Because problem is not the language. Language problem is a very one-third of the problem that you're having. The other problem is your knowledge about the subject and your skills of communication. These two things can help you overtake the problem of language that you have. Next is planning. As I already said, that when you set a goal, you have the capacity and not only you have the capacity, you also have the time and the organization to plan. If you don't know where you want to reach, what are you going to plan about? So a planning is necessary, but that can be done only when we set proper goals. So goal setting is some very important part of our corporate life, and that is a thing that I'll be discussing in the next week. So let us finish about time management first. Next is when we think that some particular task is not that important, we can just delegate it to someone else and that someone else will do it for us and we don't need to think about it. So delegation is another time management. And last thing is stress management. This is something which we had done in previous classes. You know a good bit of stress management, how to manage stress, how to help avoid stress, to keep yourself healthy, what to do to help yourself in these stages. So these are certain things you know how to handle stress in a positive way. Time management skills are important because of two reasons. One is it is a very important part of your life when you start working for yourself, when you are responsible for many things in your life. It is a very important part of your life. Another thing is you need to know in details about all these things, because when you go for a job, when you apply for a job, how well a time manager you are is going to be one of your HR questions. Very important question in the HR round. So you have to say when you have when you had a big responsibility and how you had managed to manage your time to take care of your responsibility and all at the same time not give up on the commitment or the responsibilities that you had normally have in your life. You are not disrupting other things of your life, but still taking care of a particular emergency or a particular job that has come up or stuff like that. How to improve time management skills. This is the most important thing that we have to talk about. So time management skills can be improved by three things that are given here, three very major things. So they ask you to set up short-term and long-term goals. Suppose, let me take an example of you becoming, trying to establish your business and make a profit of 5 lakh rupees in 5 years time. So right from today, in the fifth year, you would have established your business and you are making a profit of 5 lakh rupees. Anything, you can think about it monthly or yearly, that is up to you according to your business. So 5 lakh rupees a month. The first important thing at the present moment, since you are a student in third year, is that you have no idea of what business you can start. Number one. Number two, where will you get your capital? How to invest in certain things? Number three is what type of task would be necessary for that? What type of orders would you need to go through that? Now to accomplish this long-term goal, we need to make certain short-term goals. First thing we have to decide is if it is 5 lakh rupees per year, then that's not a huge amount for a business. But that doesn't mean that it is going to be a very small one, because first thing is the business needs to be implemented, started, and then it has to accomplish something, otherwise it won't make profit. So the profit is 5 lakhs. That means expenses should remain either in the negative or zero. That means whatever you are investing in, whatever you are spending on, you have to have that amount of money and then 5 lakh rupees. So let us take for granted that this entire thing is about 15 lakh or maybe a little bit more, 20 lakh. So your long-term goal is to have 20 lakhs, not as profit, but in total. So now you have to break it down that how much should you have in the fourth year, how much should you have before that, what should you do? So first thing is you have no idea of what the business you are going to start. So your shortest term goal would be to find out what is interesting for you and where you can go into business. And then we can just plan it out accordingly. Now I'll come to the next point, is managing your calendar. I'll come back to this first point later on. But first, let me talk about the second one, managing your calendar. Now, many of us have a work calendar. Many of us have both a work and a personal one, where the work part is also added. Some cases the work part is not added if it is a too jumbled up situation. If there are many tasks that you need to do in the work situation, then it's advisable to have two separate calendars. But certain things should be common in both the calendars. Number one is your short-term goal, which is what you have to find out. Break it down into smaller chunks, because you have taken the long-term goal and have brought it down and broken it down into small yearly goals or 6 monthly goals maybe. preferably yearly goals. Now you have broken that yearly goal down into even smaller chunks of monthly goals. So if that is the case, then what you have to do is on the calendar, you have to mark these places where you are keeping your short-term goals. What type of activity of the short-term goal that you need to complete every single day or every single week. After that, you said that you have to chalk down the meetings, which means that any other distractions or meetings that you have, which means there are certain tasks which you cannot avoid. So this certain tasks has to be, if you know beforehand, this has to be demarcated and separated and kept aside so that you do not overburden yourself. Because that particular area of the day is already engaged. Whatever you are going to add in has to be added by avoiding this particular part. So those things, those distractions or those meetings or certain phone calls or all these things should be, I mean, put in first in the calendar. Next is, it is advisable to demarcate the holidays that you can have. Some holidays that are declared by our country and all the stuff that needs to be demarcated. More importantly, you need to demarcate some outings that you're going to take. Suppose you have a long weekend of Friday, Saturday, Sunday, or maybe Saturday, Sunday, Monday, something like that, and you plan that out previously. You have to plan about that particular area to take a break. That should be a break entirely from what you are doing. It should be a proper outing with yourself or your family and all those things. So that, so when you demarcate it in your calendar, what you do is you are reminding yourself to make this commit, to make this commitment or to do all the reservations of the hotels and the transportation and all these things. And also you need to take care of all the work that you have at your present position that you are working in. You have to take care of all the tasks that can prevent you from getting the leave or prevent you from leaving your home or any other place for a few days where you will not be reachable by your company. Next is prioritize your assignments. Now this is, again, as I said, that you need to break down your bigger goal into smaller chunks into even smaller ones, but then you have to go into daily basis activities that you are planning to take to fulfill your bigger goal. Now that is one priority that you have already set yourself up. Next priority can be your office provided work, whether you are working from home or working from the, from any other place. So that is another thing that we need to do. And last but not the least is your priority of your family responsibility that you have. So if you can do these three things, you can be sure that you are having a very organized and time efficient work ahead of work that you're doing. Next page that I'll share with you is this one. So let me minimize my screen. Here are certain time management skills that are given. Another similar article like thing that I have shared in your mails. So see, they are showing you certain urgent tasks that you cannot avoid. Answering the phone, going to the dentist, picking up your children, reading an emails, checking out Facebook, not any specific work, but just browsing through. In that case, what we can do is, when we have certain such important things, what we can do is we can just distribute it in this way. Primary important activity, then second, third things that we need to do, things that we don't need to immediately take action, or we can delegate it to someone, and certain other tasks which, I mean, do not require any type of input, urgency, skills, etc. Here we have certain examples. Individual judgment, there's a warning there, a cast, win-win situation of a delegation that has happened in a company, so that is a real life situation that you have there, and certain tips that they have given. So take certain things that appear extra for you, and just what should I say? Certain things in our life that is not something we use on a daily basis. So we can just throw it off, and it will save us some time, because we don't need to move around arranging it and stuff like that. Next thing that this article tells us, that we need to prepare a to-do list every day. But even if you're preparing a to-do list, remember that your to-do list should not be more than 5-6 tasks. Otherwise, it is impossible to complete it within one single day. I don't think I have any more things to talk about here. It is more or less clear here, so you can go up and do it. Next thing that I'll be doing is I'll share with you the assignment. Now, I have seen that Markout has asked you to write blogs, articles online. So this is one suggestion of article that you can write. You can send it to me. I'll check it out, and you can go ahead and post it online. While you're writing the 7 effective time management skills, let me tell you that this is, just a moment, web address. So this is skills you need. A website where there are personal skills, interpersonal skills, leadership skills, everything given. In the personal skills, there are emotional intelligence. You can just go back, and from there I got the time management. So you can just go back and check it out to find any other similar topics. You can even send me a mail back with some links, and we can work on those important topics also. Otherwise, I'll just try to keep it within the syllabus that you should have been following, that you would have been following, so that it helps you in your corporate life in the later date. think I have any more things to share with you. So I think we can finish off our class here today. Meet me same time next week so that we can continue on our goal planning and goal setting.